All right, and next up is the Saturday Night Slams.
Alrighty. Slambos and the Slambies.
Yep. Okay, going on to Saturday Night Slams. So, Walter, your show took, like, about, like, half an hour.
Yeah. All right.
Let's just get things started, shall we?
All right.
Here from
let's hear from Luke Harper.
What's he got to say here at the John J. Lamoni High School Auditorium in East Rutherford, New Jersey?
Or maybe the Miz has gone full evil. He's become Vince McMahon's evil pawn.
We won't know what happened until Trey decides in Creator Wrestler.
Yeah, we won't know until I actually take the time and make changes, which may or may not happen because I'm a lazy bastard.
But for now, we're going back to the 90s. Some sweet video toaster action.
It's not even so much video toaster. This is like video, like toaster oven.
Ah. Powerful enough to...
This is video easy bake oven.
Yeah. This is video toaster as run on a literal toaster.
Yeah, just powerful enough to heat your pop-ups.
Hey, the chair is gone!
Yeah, no, we had our damn...
No, it's still there! It just moved to the other side of the ring! What is this chair, man?
We told him to move the chair!
Did you tell them who is off the stage?
Apparently not.
Oh my god, you're gonna have to be more specific with this guy!
Well, it's too late now. It's time for Saturday Night Slams! Brought to you by the Jimmy John's off Route 94.
Womp, womp. Well done, you hyped that up. You hyped that up happening earlier in the show. Well done.
Christian wants to know what you have against chairs.
It's not supposed to be there. We established early on that chair is kind of a safety hazard.
It's left over from a high school production of Arsenic and Old Lace.
We might hear from him. Maybe he just wants a friend, Cole. Let's listen in as he addresses the WWE Universe.
Shh. Luke Harper has got opinions, and he's about to share them with us.
And most of those are going to be him sounding like Jim Henson's jug band fan Muppet.
Just treat drag feet in the Mississippi mud.
Yeah, that guy.
Okay. Oh.
And then you need to choose what you're going to say.
All right, WWE Universe, let's get excited. We are here live tonight. We are going to have some fun. Are you guys ready for a good time? You ready to witness something never before seen or heard? Then let's get this party started. There's a food chain in the WWE. And WWE champion at the bottom is me, and I've been at the bottom far too long. I'm hungry, starving for something more. I've been getting the nibbles, bites, scraps, and leftovers. Now I want the main course.
A strong reaction. Strong face reaction.
I've let myself stagnate in WWE far too long. I've watched too many other superstars climb the ladder and leave me behind. Time for change. Time for new me. One bolder, faster, better, stronger, more aggressive. One focuses on me and my needs. You know what? Doesn't matter if the authority listens to me or not. I'm self-made. I'm the master of my own destiny. Don't even care who's in charge. I'm going to keep doing my thing. I'm going to come out here and prove I'm the best.
Eat more.
The fans are eating it up.
I don't think I've ever had a crowd as good as you guys. You get me. I came out here saying what I had to say, and you were listening to every word. Couldn't ask for better people than themselves. Thank you, WWE Universe.
And most importantly, screw you guys!
Now we know what we have. I thought that was a reasonably coherent promo. Yeah. Look, 1788 points.
And clear. Not bad.
The WWE Universe is behind that statement. No doubt that face about job. That.
That's the happiest we've ever seen Luke Harper.
Yeah.
Look into this card. I just got to rub my hands together and smile.
A triple threat
match is next.
Jim Neidhart, Dude Love, and Hideo Itami. Honestly, I'm gonna skip this one.
All right, good.
Okay.
Not super interested in any of these guys. Don't have anything interesting going on with them.
All right. Well, Square to Simulate. Oh, Jim Neidhart.
Next up, Andre the Giant versus Bo Dallas.
You got your momentum set to low.
Yeah, hit triangle to...
There you are.
In the most ill-advised rivalry of Bo Dallas's life... Let's see how this goes down.
Now, usually Luke Harper just like stands behind Bray Wyatt and goes,
he's a hillbilly druid.
Yeah.
Usually,
his extent to the team is like just standing behind Bray Wyatt.
But spoiler alert: none of the promos in this are remotely in character. There's a couple of scripts, and that's about it.
Yeah, basically a lot of, like, choose option A, B, or C, and ND, and see which one, and string together the most coherent thing you can.
All right, John J. Lamoni High School Auditorium is ready for Andre the Giant. No, we didn't.
This music, like whenever he came out, he usually came out to nothing.
Bo Dallas would not take the peanut! My entire feud with Bo Dallas is because he would not take the peanut!
It's as good an explanation as any.
Here we go, singles action on the way. I've been waiting for this to get started. Here we go!
Bo Dallas has somehow pissed off Andre the Giant
leading up to again.
And, last week, as you may recall, he managed to fight Andre the Giant to a draw, by which I mean he took the fight out of the ring, and it was a double count-out.
Really, the best you can ask for in a fight with Andre the Giant.
Especially if you're Bo Dallas. So, let's see if he manages to pull off another miracle this week. By miracle, I mean survive.
His music is rather miraculous.
Yeah. Believes.
Believe me.
It stinks. All right, and here we go.
This is a one-on-one matchup.
That's what we're looking for from the Andre the Giant Bo Dallas matchup. Bo Dallas just getting kicked in the face and knocked to the ground.
Yes.
See some blood, sweat, and tears. They're about to get it.
Yes. And Bo just hanging out on the turnbuckle.
Bo forgot what he was going to do.
Yeah. Well, Bo did just get booted in the goddamn face. He might not know where he is.
Doesn't know why he's here.
Well, where he is at the John Jamina High School gym.
John J. Lamoni High School Auditorium, yes.
And John Jacob Jingleheimer Schmidt Auditorium.
Oh, that too.
Talk about getting launched. Right, his name is the high school's name too.
It is. Oh, and Andre the Giant giving Bo Dallas a serious doogie. That being
in the ring with Andre the Giant, the kids will always shout, "I go to John J. Lamoni." It's difficult to get any real offense going against
him. In the back rake.
Oh, scratching the itch that Bo Dallas just couldn't reach.
Oh! Big old body drop onto the plywood.
Oh. That'll give Bo Dallas a splinter. He's trying real hard to hold down Andre the Giant.
Yeah.
That's not going to work.
That's not going to work. Obviously needs glasses. Big beefy clothesline from Andre. You're not the only one who's had trouble finding a counter for Andre's power. Some of the big ol' elbow. Industry have found themselves overpowered
by the eighth wonder of the world. Well, you got that right. Andre's overpowered everybody from Ernie Ladd to Big John.
Yeah, he did not look like he was picking up Andre there. Most of other super heavyweights.
There's just no matching his combination of size and strength. Goes, but instead of a plain white sheet, it's a sheet. And it's Andre the Giant able to break free.
He took an incredible pounding there. Andre looking at this quickly.
All right. And the boots to the bone.
Kneeing the general vicinity of his head.
Yeah.
Her sheet was a weighted therapy blanket, so she can't put the pop on it. Gained the upper hand.
The human body can only absorb so much of that.
Big old
bulldog.
Expecting to bounce back though.
With again some weird physics at the edge of the ring. Although, let's be fair, anything you do to Andre the Giant is going to be close enough to the edge of the ring for Andre to hit it.
Yeah. Basically, any place is to the edge of the ring. It's been a great matchup to this point, and this could really go either way.
Bo Dallas playing his game on the road here tonight. He's pulling out all the stops. I just want to take the peanut! Few superstars are as dominant as this guy.
Why won't you take the peanut?
Oh my, there's the
eat the peanut. Eat the peanut now. He's got the ropes
and the pin is broken. Dragging him around like he's not.
Choke on the peanut.
He's choking. Oh, and that's a hell of a Heimlich. That'll squash you flat. To get that peanut out of Bo Dallas' throat.
I am a helper. I can't believe what I just saw. And big ol' stomp.
I think a stomp just a walking off.
Yeah. And big old backdrop.
If nothing else, this rivalry has drastically improved Bo Dallas' upper body strength. Oh my goodness!
Oh, what's he doing here?
What's going on? Oh!
He did a thing.
I gotta admit, these displays of sheer power might yet make a believer out of me. I'm not sure, King.
You really should believe in Bo Dallas. As long as he's not taking the peanut, he's good.
I mean, everyone thought he was a useless wimp, but because weight classes have been turned off, he can pick up Andre the Giant.
Andre looking a little off his game here. Andre's got to be hurt here. I don't know if we've ever seen the eighth wonder of the world in this type of predicament.
Man, Andre might be reeling, but a regular human being would have been knocked out a long time ago.
Scaling the turnbuckles, broke down. Coming
up to the top.
He's now almost as tall as Andre the Giant. The slower
and
slower he is getting
back to his feet. He's taking some time to... And a big old splash.
Let's be fair, that's the only way he's going to get Andre's face. Later!
Bo's trying to figure out, kind of still out of it from that boot at the start.
Bo's just going for a walk.
Now he's playing to the crowd. And then Bo is...
If he can lure Andre out, he might be able to pull off another draw. He's just—he's heading backstage.
Bo realizes he cannot.
This is Bo Dallas's smartest move.
I think Bo thinks he won. I think
Bo might actually think the match is over. Oh no! Oh! Oh! Oh God!
Big old butt back suplex.
Bo realizes he cannot defeat Andre in the ring. Spring left in his step right now.
He's freaking out, grabbing his head.
And it's apparent if he gets back in the ring right now. With a 180, Bo Dallas the reversal.
Bo is just done.
Well, Bo is just out of here.
What? God, this guy! Try and make me eat the peanut. I don't want a peanut.
He is lecturing Andre the Giant.
I just wanted to tell you about the peanut.
Another draw!
The match is
some
over.
Amazing strategy from Bo Dallas.
Yeah.
Not fighting Andre the Giant again! Are we going to have to put these two in a cage?
It looks like.
They'll find a way to leave.
Oh, what God. Is even up next?
Don't change the channel. We have singles.
Mark Henry versus Kalisto.
All right, this will be our Jimmy John's International Hokey Belt Champion, Mark Henry, against Kalisto in another mismatched weight battle. Although, let's be fair, Kalisto is much more credible opposition than Bo Dallas. But yes, our singles title, the Jimmy John's International Hoagie Flavor Belt. Which I don't even remember what I set the announcer to call it.
Let's find out.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. From Silsby, Texas, weighing in at 399 pounds, the International Mixed Heritage Champion, the world's strongest man.
International Mixed Heritage Champion.
All right.
I don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, is a pure wrecking machine.
Man, oh man. Mark Henry.
I don't tend to name belts things that the AI can handle.
The man that has to face him. The WWE Universe on its feet. Looking
the Jimmy John's belt gives him like...
Made out of luxurious vinyl.
Vinyl. I think it gives him sweet discounts at the local Jimmy
Yes, he gets 10% off at the Jimmy John's off Route 94. And for a man like Mark Henry, that's a lot of money saved.
Oh, indeed.
From Mexico City, Mexico.
Now, Kalisto had a pretty impressive showing against the Natural Disasters last week.
He did. We'll see if he can handle himself against another extremely big man, the strongest man alive, and the tastiest hoagie alive, Mark Henry. Let's see if he can bring some South of the Border spice to the Hoagie K Championship.
I heard he wanted to rename it the Gordon Championship.
Yes, the
Tortilla Championship, yeah. Yes.
Let's ease this joke back before we accidentally go somewhere racist.
Okay. I'm trying to say, they don't have Jimmy John's down there, so they have to rename the belt.
There's no other way to put it.
No, it's the International Hoagie Championship.
International Hoagie Championship.
Neither man looks like they're remotely entertaining the idea of backing down. This is gonna be good.
Yeah. Oh! That was almost plausible, too. They hadn't, like, interacted with the ropes. Because nothing in this game is plausible once you interact with the ropes. Doing a few little hops and getting up from the top of the rope. Oh!
There are, in fact, Mexican hoagies.
All right.
6 inch long tortilla, 1.5 pounds of Italy-sliced smoked turkey breast.
This isn't really Mexican.
My first chance to get a look at
delicious tortilla.
So it'll be exciting to
see what you can
do. Mark Henry going for the baseball bat we saw on Wednesday.
Oh, this is from. Oh, this is the recipe before.
I mean, it's definitely a first tonight.
Yeah.
And
the bat flies off into space, never to be seen again.
the bat has nuked right out of the arena.
And now he goes for
and some kicks and punch.
Now bear in mind, one punch from Mark Henry is like eight punches from Kalista. This is the strongest man alive. He bench presses cars and eats motorcycles.
How is this Oriental ginger beef Mexican home? What? How is this? The world's
strongest man is don't intense, judge until you try it. Oh, just getting pounded by the Hoagie champion. This is not looking good for Kalista.
That's cool. I like new stuff.
Kalista. Big beefy elbow.
Ref leaping out of the way. Tortas are honestly like they're not shaped like hoagies, but they do the Jimmy John's thing of like the scooping arm, right? So tortas would be sort of the regional analog to Jimmy John's, as Tim was saying.
The pure power of Mark Henry, the world's strongest man, crushes anything he touches. His mean streak fuels an endless assault for whoever sets foot in the ring against him. This is the man who broke the world record for pulling
a double. This is what Saturday Night Slams is all about. Enormous, beefy men pounding the shit out of people much tinier than him. That's what Bo Dallas is making a mockery of. Every time he leads Andre the Giant out of the ring. It's like WCW, except people actually move. Just huge guys beating the shit out of luchadors. He's crawling on all fours like a baby. Because the strongest man in the world does what he wants. If he
can't reverse, are you going to tell him this?
No. I'm not gonna. He might bench press me and eat me.
No, Mark Henry's not a cannibal.
That's true. He only eats hoagies and motorcycles.
He is the father to a rubber glove, though.
Yeah.
Well, that's all right because he's never eaten rubber gloves either. On purpose.
Now, Trey, that's a different reality. Like, oh, and this
is it. Oh, this is why you don't jump at Mark Henry.
Oh,
he will bench press you and eat you.
This is insane.
Is this it? Yeah, he...
Oh, Kalisto demolished by the strongest man alive. Really? We could have seen that coming. Oh. So Mark Henry retains the Jimmy John's International Hoagie Belt.
Here's your winner, which gets him free food at Jimmy John's as long as he is the champion.
10% off plus free bag of chips with every sandwich and soda. Impressive fashion.
You have to imagine Kalisto. Well, just a free sandwich. He only is 10% off. Guys,
no.
He gets the basic discount that you can get like almost any other way.
Well, I mean, to be fair, with Mark Henry, that adds up quickly to entire sandwiches.
Mark Henry. For some reason, we're seeing Bo Dallas without even a giant stats.
Who knows, folks?
Up next is the big one.
And we have the Natural Disasters versus the Wyatt family. The Natural Disasters are, of course, the current holders of the John J. Lamone Fighting Squids Tag Team Belt.
And they're going up against the Wyatt family.
Yes, the Wyatt family, in the absence of Bray Wyatt, have coalesced around a common leader, the enormous brawny Braun Strowman.
Braun Strowman.
This is, of course, a show that is built on beefiness, and that makes Braun Strowman the natural leader for the Wyatt family in Bray's absence. But when it comes to beefiness, these two are hard to beat.
The following tag team contest is an elimination tag team match. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 852 pounds, Earthquake and Typhoon, the Natural Disaster.
Man, both of these teams are determined to walk away with a win.
Again.
Something's
got to give. Is that even just the announcing, right?
Lillian just cannot handle it.
She's supposed to say Earthquake and Typhoon, the champion. She's going Earthquake and Typhoon.
Yeah, I think to like adjust like the booking, you have. Oh, trippy. Yeah, I think like to adjust like the booking of the matches, you have to do it like before the show starts. That's why I think you have to. It has like an edit option before the show starts. So to avoid like, you know, like elimination tag things.
And the tag team scene has been on fire of late here in WWE. And I think we're about to see another highlight. This duo has
all the makings of being one of the... Man, they kind of fit in with the scenery here.
Yeah, they kind of do. WWE
ring. Okay, it gives it a sort of a last known footage vibe.
Yeah, it really does.
Kind of Wyatt, the Hands of Fate. Eric Rowan takes care of the house while the master's away.
I wonder if they will have any thoughts about Luke Harper's face turn earlier tonight.
Yeah.
this really, who isn't a Typhoon fan?
Yeah. He will shock you.
These dudes were pretty early in my draft. Braun Strowman has stepped nicely into the leadership void left by Bray Wyatt.
Yeah, this could be a pretty solid match here.
This could be. We've got some extremely large men in this ring.
Set to start things off here. We're ready to go.
Well, a team is only as strong as its weakest link, and time will tell who's the weak link here tonight.
Let's talk more action. Let's go.
Well, regardless, we're underway and rolling on another great WWE event.
And another big old flip.
Concentrating on the face.
He
now
is getting earthquaked. Not an auspicious start for Braun Strowman.
Punch to the gut. A good partner is as important as anything else. How can he do his part tonight in this one?
I like the pairing.
Lifting him up like nuts.
It looks less ridiculous when Earthquake does it than when Bo Dallas does it, to be fair.
Pretty much, yeah.
So I'm looking forward to seeing if he can impress me in the ring right now. Making a statement here.
These two have been some pretty impressive stars so far in Saturday Night Slams. The Natural Disasters have put on some pretty impressive performance.
Camel clutch.
They've been grabbed in the head by Braun Strowman.
And sling him face first into the ropes.
Take a look at that. We haven't seen that one tonight.
I love something new.
Braun's having none of that. And neither is Earthquake.
Earthquake is not that easy to stop. You can't stop a natural disaster that easily.
You cannot stop something that can't be stopped.
He's going to walk around a little and throw him back into the corner.
Yep, and in comes Typhoon.
Oh, snap! Two at a time.
Right in the double J.
Right onto the plywood.
Now, if you land on the target, I hear you get a 5% discount on your next purchase.
You actually, if you get slammed right in the Jimmy Jones, you will get buy one, get one on your next purchase of the Jimmy Jones outstanding.
Nice.
So,
at the Jimmy John's off Route 94.
Does that go to Braun Strowman or the Natural Disasters?
That goes to the Natural Disasters.
All right, then.
That's a hoagie for each of them. You'll see them aiming for the Jimmy John's target throughout the match, trying to rack up those hoagies, because these are two very hungry men.
So the slams are cumulative.
Oh, yeah. Every slam right in the Jimmy John's is another buy one, get one coupon.
Nice.
For fresh hot hoagies at Jimmy John's. Punched out of the ring.
Yep, and out goes Rowan.
Well, that's the first time we've seen that move tonight from either locker room.
I kind of love it.
Big ol' knee.
Flipping him over entirely. Typhoon not putting on as good a show as Earthquake did.
But there we go.
That's what we're looking for.
Now, is this an elimination match or a simple tag match?
This is elimination tag.
As usual.
Yeah, I think he's got things going his way.
I don't know if we've seen that from him before. I mean, it's definitely a first tonight.
This is great. This guy will try anything. It looks like we're going to see what kind
of... giving him those nice shoulder chops to work out the tension. And then stomping on him like a shiatsu masseur.
Yep.
He's certainly showing us something new from his...
People have things to beat.
That's cool. Disaster's just making sure these hillbilly druids know what they're getting into.
Yeah.
Neither men caring about the count out.
Yeah,
they beat druids, but they can't stand up to the most
aggressive
creature. Typhoon suddenly realizing he's in a wrestling match. Here we go again.
I'm coming back.
Just broke the count for reasons.
He likes it out here. It's refreshing.
What's the reason?
Hey! I don't know why, but I feel like the guys on my show act a lot goofier.
Sounds like they're up to five.
No way he's going to be able to stand after that.
Well, man, he's going off here.
He doesn't care about winning. He just cares about punishing the Wyatt family for their hubris.
Yeah.
And it's apparent if he gets back in the ring right now.
Besides, he knows that Earthquake can handle Braun Strowman.
Momentum.
Oh, snap! Oh, and barely sneaking it back into the ring.
I can't do it! Oh, God!
I don't even know what that was. Oh, and there's another buy one, get one hoagie coupon.
Typhoon using the dreaded ass attack.
Can make it hard to breathe.
Earthquake just rocking Eric Rowan. Not quite hitting the target. So no hoagie for the Wyatt tonight.
One move after the other. It's devastating.
This is hard to watch. This is going to be bad.
Starting to shake a bit here. Ron Strowman, one of the few men in this division strong enough, actually one of quite a few men in this division, strong enough to pick up Earthquake. Let's be honest. We've got Andre the Giant. We've got the Big Show. We've got Mark Henry.
We have Bo Dallas.
Yeah.
We have Bo Dallas, who is strong enough to pick up anything and then leave.
I
have a theory, gentlemen.
What?
Bo Dallas is actually a surviving Daxamite. Is that coming in with the same powers?
Yeah.
He's a surviving Daxamite, but he gets worried every time he accidentally goes with powers in the same ring.
Oh, and wow.
I think Braun's he's just freakishly strong.
Yeah, and Braun just like lifting Earthquake around.
This is not where the comic book stuff happens.
Well, you know, things do happen from time to time.
Family.
Like people being brought back from the
That's just good old-fashioned street necromancy.
You said it, and he does not want to let his opponent gain some steam here and start to get
slam him in the butt by Wyatt. That is Chuck Tingle's wrestling endorsement.
Yeah. Chuck Tingle loves wrestling. He loves watching the handsome WrestleMans.
Yeah?
No, he does.
He posts about it.
Oh, he does?
Like, he doesn't post about wrestling, but, like,
and
he posts
to... having enough of this.
Now he's just going for a stroll.
Yep, now he's out of here.
He posts, like, a lot of, like, weird memes of, like, if he keeps up this pace, wrestlers, this real ugly, like, real looping gifs of wrestlers with completely inexplicable facts over them.
And, what's going on?
Whoa, he just,
face first.
Picking out Earthquake like a sack of coffee.
Find a way to collect himself after that.
Okay, this...
Shoulders down, is it enough? This may be it.
Oh, interference from Typhoon.
You can yes,
had enough.
Feel
the he is not the legal man.
This match.
But bear in mind, if there's a disqualification here, the natural disasters will retain the belt.
Eric
Rowan is still recovering from that horrible beating from the outside.
Look at the post. Now, the posts here are all-natural recycled railway ties, actually. We couldn't afford metal posts.
Now that's how you do it. I don't remember the last time he executed that maneuver. Well, I've never seen him do that before.
Oh, this could be it. Oh, snap. Time for an earthquake.
Oh! Questionable physics aside, that looked like it hurt.
Well, and Eric Rowan is completely fucked.
Oh, elbow right to the face.
Earthquake's so powerful it broke reality. Oh, and he's putting the boost to the earthquake.
Eric Rowan in the grips of a fit of rage. Bear in mind, this is a man whose mind has been shattered by the Wyatt family. He will go berserk if his family is threatened. I guess. Probably? Seems plausible, yeah?
Yep.
You'll notice that the natural disasters have an extremely butt-centric fighting style, yes. It's part of their charm. Whoa! Somehow he did not fly out of the ring there. Ah, a little bit relaxing massage to soften him up.
Yeah, get the kink out of the collar.
Get him off guard. Now that he's completely relaxed, we drag him over and follow him.
Oh, exactly. It's
big
old
elbow.
And this type of match is pure chaos. It's good they have two shoulders because they'll need to look over both of them in this one. Here's the cover for the win.
Barely a one count.
Yeah, Earthquake is not out of it yet. Earthquake could fight Eric Rowan all day.
Yeah.
Most people fight Eric Rowan. To be fair, I mean, this guy was beat in his middle of 3 seconds.
Really?
I'd say not much longer.
Well, you know, The Rock is way too cool to be in this league.
Yeah, The Rock is right in this league. And he spin kicked nothing.
Well, bear in mind, this is a man who, as part of the Wyatt family, sees ghosts. Occasionally... Oh! Another butt slam!
Most people see ghosts. Yeah,
ghosts.
No, he said ghosts.
I said ghosts.
I'm pretty sure I'm ghosts.
Well, he sees ghosts, too, but he also sees ghosts, and occasionally the ghosts of goats.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, the ghost goats.
Now, do ghost goats eat ghost grass?
They eat the ghost grease on the grass left by the ghost bees.
Ah.
They're gross ghosts.
Well done, sir. Well done.
Anyway, natural disasters won.
Yep.
Slammed in the butt by the natural disasters.
Slammed by the butt, see.
No, he was slammed by the butt of a natural disaster.
Yeah.
Earthquake does the thing where he jumps up and drops his butt on the other guy. He did it multiple times here.
And Tugboat Typhoon.
You want to talk about tag team war? We most definitely witnessed
Tugboat Shockmaster Typhoon.
A clinic in tag team wrestling. Kudos to everyone.
I love tag team matches, and that was one of the best I've seen in a while.
Wow.
That was a pretty good tag team match. What's up next?
Typhoon is seeing a lot of things.
We got one-on-one action coming your way next, King.
Dudley versus Rikishi.
We have a real fan favorite. We want to watch this one?
A match that is sure to not disappoint.
As you can see, I haven't really done anything goofy with these guys yet.
I can't wait to see these two go at it.
We can probably bypass them.
Yeah.
If I'll let you bypass them. Mine wouldn't let me back out to bypass a match after I did one.
Oh. Oh, there it goes. Yeah, think about it for a moment. I hit the,
That skips entrances.
Okay. Hit the options button.
That's what I'm doing. Happens.
Oh, okay. We can just go next match. Yeah, that works.
Oh, that works too.
I'll figure out something to do with those guys. Don't you worry.
Now don't go anywhere.
And now it's our ultimate dragon champion, Bam Bam Bigelow, versus Luke Harper, who had some unusually incoherent, actually unusually coherent for Luke Harper, things to say earlier tonight.
Look at those beard physics.
The Ultimate Dragon.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making its
Not
way to
the ring. The Ultimate Dragon.
From Asbury Park, New Jersey, weighing in at 390 pounds, the Dragon, Raw and Dragon Champion, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Dragon, Raw and Dragon.
For a drink tonight. Both of these superstars look geared up
yes.
and ready to
Dragon,
go.
Dragon.
But Dragon, the Dragon, Dragon was in Chikara.
This is Dragon, Dragon, Rock the Dragon. It's close to that idea.
Yeah.
Dragon, Dragon, Raw, Dragon. But this is the Ultimate Dragon Championship, which is the prestige belt of Saturday Night Slayers. The most coveted belt in the division.
You can feel the intensity level inside the
Luke Harper doesn't appear to be entirely clear on where he is or what he's doing here.
Yeah, his mind has been blown.
Which one is truly the best?
He's not quite sure where he's at.
Although it is, in fact, clearly labeled as John Maloney High School.
Indeed.
In July 2000, Bam Bam Bigelow received second-degree burns on 40% of his body while rescuing three children from a burning house near his home.
Huh.
Following the incident, he spent 2 months recovering in a hospital.
Based on the electricity that traveling through this arena at decibel level.
And now he's kicking the shit out of Luke Harper.
The roof of this building just might blow off. Yeah, social media has been on fire ahead of this one. But now it's time to get down to business. Mono a mono. One fall will
Bam Bam Bigelow, one of the strongest contenders in this division, and that's why he is the Ultimate Dragon Champion.
They came here to see some blood, sweat, and tears. To get it. What's your analysis of Bam Bam Bigelow?
The ease with which Bam Bam Bigelow is getting around the ring tonight is truly amazing. Sometimes you forget he is a super heavyweight.
Well, this is my first chance to get a look at this superstar, so it'll be exciting to see what he can do.
It's King Michael Cole and JBL.
Oh, JBL's on this one. Okay.
Luke Harper stands 6'5".
Oh, that was an impressive toss.
And I think that earned Luke Harper a hoagie.
Yeah, he's got a hoagie coupon.
Yes. He's got one more than the rest of the Okami community.
It remains to be seen if he will share and with whom.
It's downright scary. He may be going into business for himself.
Or at least going to dinner by himself.
Yeah. I think Luke Harper's mind has been blown because he's fighting a dead dude.
When you reach this level of aggression,
he totally thought Bam Bam was dead.
Oh, there's no stopping this guy.
Well, you know, that's not really a big sticking point in this. Oh! And the hoagie for Bam Bam!
That's the way he has to be if he wants to win here tonight. You know, Cole, it's frightening how Luke Harper uses all of his abilities to ravage an opponent.
I like how he says that while Luke Harper is writhing in pain on the floor after Bam Bam slams him. Oh, right in the Jimmy John's once more.
Yep, another hoagie for Bam Bam.
Bam Bam Bigelow is just racking up the hoagies tonight.
I don't think I've ever seen him look more motivated than he looked heading into this match. It's a good point, John. And I'd say this match is about as even as it could get at this point. The strikes have a little extra on them tonight.
That's an interesting idea.
Yeah.
If you take enough shots to the back of the head sooner or later, you're going to be seeing
these stars.
Yeah, or at least looking up at the lights.
Like, I blinked, and then he was in a different place.
Yeah, he kind of like slid right into position here.
He knows his opponent is completely helpless to resist the submission hold. Can he do it? Can he dig down deep and fight out of this hold? Hey! And he fights.
Apparently,
yes.
He's zeroing in on the arm now. Bam!
I know. I still favor Bam Bam for this one. I'm going to just back up into the ref for a while.
Right on the ref. And now he's going to stop around.
Nice throw.
Expect him to bounce back, though. This is the type of
one-on-one. Hug him a little.
But it's important to know that this match has been so evenly contested so far. You really can't pick a winner. And on top of that, John, these two guys couldn't be any.
Oh, punch right out of the ring. Are we going to see a repeat of earlier tonight? Twice? When people get out of the ring and just decide to walk away? No, he's thrown back into the ring by Bam Bam Bigelow.
He's thinking.
Here we go. Back inside the ring.
It's the ring smarts of the champion here.
Yeah, no, the champion knows what he's doing. Bam Bam on the top rope. Oh, that's going to hurt.
Man, oh man. He needs to pull things together here.
Two count.
Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there.
Bam Bam just running right through the ref.
Yeah. Back to his feet. And another splash.
That phased him. I mean, there's no way it couldn't have. Yep, there's the reversal by Luke Carter. And here's a cover.
Barely a lung count, though.
Bam Bam is nowhere near low on steam.
He's in full-on attack mode now.
The Bam Bam does not stop.
Bam Bam is, in fact, in control.
Somebody's going to get hurt in this match.
And goes on. Just elbows right around.
Wow, yeah, this sort of flipped put Bam Bam ass over tea kettle.
Oh my! Oh!
Denied.
Slow count by the ref.
This is closer than I was expecting, I will say.
Yeah.
Now, is this an actual championship match? Could we have a new Ultimate Dragon champion?
As the general manager, let me assure you, I have no idea. I barely know what's going on here.
He may be near, folks. This is not where he wants to be at this point in this match. And Michael, given
I think something may be amiss here. It's two very slow counts.
Well, let's not forget that the ref was knocked from it by Bam Bam earlier.
Oh, and Bam Bam doing a nice little clip before.
I mean, it's a little cartwheel.
This is great. This guy will try anything. Oh, reversal. Oh. What a reversal.
And could this be enough?
Oh, reversal. And his heartless attack.
Now he reversed him into a Hogan. Here,
right oh, yeah.
Yeah.
When he gets going like this, there are a few better.
So that, now that's like, I think like two, three hoagies for a nice reversal. Oh, and
He's doing much better than the rest of the Wyatt family on his hoagie count.
Yes. Oh, and big old splash.
Diving body press from Bam Bam. Gosh, what a battle. You have to contend with the
assault. No, Luke Harper is not having this shit.
Luke Harper will not be denied.
However, that one doesn't count for the hoagie because Bam Bam was not lifted up completely off the ground.
Ah, indeed.
Somehow, he's kicked it into another gear here tonight. Things have gotten worse for Bam Bam Bigelow. Suplex face buster.
He's unorthodox.
He's really done a number on it thanks to moves like that.
He can do it here.
At least
he
can. Oh, snap. Luke has done it.
Luke Harper has defeated the champion.
Wow. Is he our new champion?
Well, let's hear.
The champion holding what? The title high and celebrating.
What?
Wait, uh-oh, hold on. Who? Yeah. What?
The fuck?
I don't know who that is.
What the fuck is going on here? Is that a character you made?
I don't know who he is.
Hey,
Tim, is that something you made?
No.
No, I mean, I made him. It's not, I made him out of a guy who I don't know who he is.
Oh.
Oh, okay. what the shit?
So apparently this was a non-title match.
The madness does not stop at Saturday Night Slams.
Well, this was completely confusing.
Hold on to your seats. We have singles action coming up next.
This is going to be good.
We have a real fan favorite.
Smash last
taking on some tough competition.
They have a rivalry.
Yeah. Okay.
Do we want to watch it or do we want to skip?
I don't know if it's going to be able to compete with the oddity of Luke Harper defeating the Dragon Raw Dragon Champion. That's what we said!
Pretty much, yeah.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making
British
his way
Bulldog
to
is a beefy, beefy
from
man.
Manchester, England. Weighing in at 260 pounds, the British Bulldog.
With all the build-up over the last few weeks, this match is guaranteed to not disappoint.
So, yeah, I know who that guy was, and I know what he wanted.
You don't know who you were.
Wait, I know. I just it's someone who I don't know who he is.
Okay, do you remember his name?
Why bother? A mysterious individual.
It wasn't Dolph Ziggler again.
Wanted something from Bam Bam.
Was it Dolph Ziggler?
But could not make out what it was through his bizarre lack of face. Like a giant smurf whose texture failed to load.
And his opponent,
the whitest man alive. Although, honestly, after that last weirdo we saw, that's a questionable assertion.
That's a new challenge.
This one's going to be electric. Man, I can't wait to see these two square off in one-on-one action.
Davey Boy Smith and Sheamus coming out to debate the current situation with Brexit.
Well, this is sort of a holdover rivalry, the Ireland versus Great Britain rivalry.
Ah, indeed.
Honestly, pretty tame by Saturday Night Slam standards.
Yeah.
Singles action is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all.
Look
you
how
do.
Amazingly well, pale Sheamus
competitors has a lot of love amazingly pale is.
So pasty. Right now,
both these superstars are going to find out about themselves real quick.
You got beef on one side and paste on the other.
If you want to bask in that WWE glory.
I guess if you go halfway between Great Britain and Ireland and you don't land in the ocean, you get Cornish pasty.
What else can we say? I mean, he can talk all at once, but
almost
he wants to be a force in the WWE. He's going to have to prove it in the ring.
Sheamus is a power kick for a temper king, and we've seen him explode many times with disastrous consequences for whomever is unlucky enough to be standing across the squared circle from him.
Yeah, you know what? His temper runs redder than his hair, Michael. The Celtic Warrior is one of the most volatile performers in all
of WWE. Yeah,
let's go
with the Brexit thing. I'm not getting into the games here. Oh, that was a direct Jimmy Johns in.
He's one mean Irishman when you get on his bad side.
Big old suplex.
Now, of course, Sheamus, being Irish, actually did not participate in Brexit.
Ah.
Nope.
At this point, it looks to me like this match is as even
so
as it
he is. He is showing the British Bulldog his mistakes.
Yeah.
He's showing him the power of the European Union.
It's a unified Europe.
Sheamus off king, and the thing about it is it doesn't take much to set off any excuse.
British Bulldog's kind of a lone wolf, but Sheamus, ooh, Sheamus, give him what for?
Yeah.
Over the past few years that only took a second to start but forever to finish.
Could Sheamus be looking to take over the Saturday Night Snaps with a European Union?
Oh, he might be, actually.
Well,
do you think he's trying to force the British Bulldog to rejoin the European Union?
Sheamus finding a path of destruction currently. I'd say that's more embarrassing than anything.
Have to figure
else.
Out what other Europeans we actually have.
Well,
yeah. Classes in his career, hasn't he?
Yeah, see if how many we have in the Saturday Night Snaps. Yeah. That could be a thing.
British Bulldog has been taking a lot of punishment in this matchup. He'll need to find
okay,
a
Sheamus
way to
says, yeah, right now, going to town on British Bulldog with the unified power of a unified Europe.
Yeah.
And tonight may just be
one nation alone can't hope to match that economic weight.
It looks like he's in no man's land here. He needs to be able to put things back together here.
Michael, this is a dangerous position to be in. He needs to be able to find a way to clear the cobwebs
right
and
nose.
Regroup. Really pushing his opponent to the limit here.
Playing mind games.
Yeah, a little intimidation there.
Doing the stompy thing?
Yep.
The extremely white noise, yes. The whitest noise alive.
He's just getting dissected. The human body was not designed to absorb this type of damage.
He might just have nothing left to give, guys.
Well, he's not looking as good as he was earlier, but that doesn't mean he's done.
Oh! That's a buy one, get one hoagie for the British Bulldog at the Jimmy John's off Route 94.
I hear he donates to the local children.
Does he now?
Yeah.
Well, that's because he's British and he thinks he's too good for our American hoagies.
Here with this attack.
He'd rather have tea and crumpets.
And chips.
Fish and chips. Bangers and mash.
Brutal and very, very painful for these guys.
And meat pie floaters.
Man,
Sheamus barely retaining his place in the European Union.
Boy, there's no way he's going to be able
but
to
not necessarily for much longer.
Oh, big old slam.
Man, that's impressive.
Wait, dragging around.
Is he still conscious?
This could be it.
And look at the Bulldog going for the cover. And he kicks out before the referee's three count.
Sheamus is not that easy to keep down. He's got that Irish pro. I mean, I guess Irish people are Irish as well.
And that's how you do it.
Oh, but that does look like it hurts, though. Oh, there we go. That's just the kind of turnaround Sheamus needs.
Sheamus showing his butt.
Doing a little booty pose.
Showing his butt.
Doing a little Marilyn Monroe there.
Showing his dance with his people. And,
into the corner.
Owie.
Is he still conscious? Man, that looked bad.
He thinks he has it. They're taking a sweet time to get in position. Three.
Almost and laying that third down.
That's right. The Sheamus retains his place at the European Union. The British Bulldog has received a powerful mandate to rejoin. We'll see if Parliament listens.
That was a hell of a match. He went through a war here tonight.
Oh, Sheamus isn't done yet.
Oh, I think he may not
Brexit.
Be finished. No, he's not.
Brexit sucks. What are you talking about, Brexit? Stop it. Just Stop it.
A little insult to injury now.
Oh, and looks like that was it.
Oh. Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that was the show.
Yeah, that was the Saturday Night Slams and Rogues Gallery.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Okay, yep. Well, that is...
Here's the control.
Thank you. Okay, so that concludes the second week of our universe here.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for tuning in. Eventually, we'll get our shows, tuned so we can actually, watch them and show them in a decent amount of time.
Yeah.
I don't know, 2 hours for, three shows kind of went pretty well.
Yeah, two...
We skipped over most of Tim's, though.
Yeah, just because, that first show ran, super long.
Yeah.
But, well... Try and get that fixed. Anyway, thanks for coming out. We'll see you next time.
Good night. Good fight.
Yes. Oh, and actually, tomorrow, hopefully tomorrow, I'll have something super cool cooked up for y'all wrestling fans.
Oh, boy.
So we'll...
Oh, boy.
Yeah. See you next time,
folks.
See
you around.
Later.